Hello, my name is Gosia Sołyga and I'm a student from Warsaw, and during last time I had an opportunity to work on one project where I had an opportunity to learn something more about Europa, and I would like to tell you something about it. So first of all, Europa, it's a moon. It's a moon of Jupiter, and together with Io, Ganymede and Callisto, it was discovered by Galileo Galilei in 17th century, like we saw yesterday on the movie. And Europa is the smallest Galilean moon, and its size is more or less the same as the size of our own moon. And Europa, it's an icy moon, and it means that the outer layer of this moon is made of ice. It's really, really interesting thing for us because we're basically looking for water, ice, or whatever in the universe. And the whole outer layer is relatively smooth and it has just few impact craters, and that means that the whole Europa is believed to be pretty, pretty young. Also, this environment is pretty cold because average temperature on Europa is around minus 170 degrees Celsius. It's extremely cold environment, and yeah, basically we can have such an environment when we're so far away from the sun. But that's not the only not pleasant thing on Europa, because also on Europa we have huge radiation doses. And this radiation dose is really, really huge, and it's lateral for almost all organisms from Earth. Just one bacteria would be able to survive in this environment, and that's it. And this is caused by the fact that Europa is situated within Jovian magnetosphere, and there the charged particles from the solar wind and from Io bombard the surface of Europa. They bombard it constantly and they destroy the ice on the surface, and they release plenty of oxygen. And this oxygen creates there some thin layer of ozone. We can see here the density of the ozone there. And we can say that this is some kind of atmosphere on this moon. And it's pretty nice. And that's it about the outer layer. Now let's have a look inside the Europa. Inside the Europa we have an iron frozen core, which is covered by the rocky mantle. And above this rocky mantle we've got the most interesting thing, because some scientists believe that there we have an ocean. We have an ocean of the salty liquid water, and this fact is really, really interesting for us because we're looking for this water all over the universe, and maybe it can support some life forms. Yeah, because also on Earth it is believed that some life started in the water, and also deep inside of the oceans we've got some strange small, or not only small, big creatures which can survive in this environment. So maybe some kind of this creatures would be also able to survive on Europa. We don't know, we have to check it, but if we've got the liquid water, it means that it's a little bit warmer there. Also the ice on the top of it protects the inside of the planet from the radiation. And okay, it's pretty away from the sun, but we've got some tidal heat in there which can give us some heat to support some life forms. But all of these things are beliefs. To check it would be good to go there. And as looking for life forms is a pretty important part of the exploring the whole universe for humans, because we're curious if there is something else or not, maybe it would be good to go to Europa and check it on our own. Okay, we had some missions which go to the Jovian system and discover it a little bit, but they are not directly related to Europa. We've got nice pictures from them, of Europa, but that's it. So it would be really, really nice to have a mission which will go to Europa and to go there and explore it more. It can be an orbiter, but if you want to see what's inside of the Europe, it would be good to create a rover or lander which could go there. But okay, such a mission could be a little bit complicated, and today with our timing with the missions, I know that it couldn't be possible for the next 30 or maybe 40 years, but maybe It would be good to stop thinking only about Mars, but start to think about other worlds to explore. And that's it. Thank you very much.
Okay, very well done, Gosia. Thank you very much. And I think that